Here we find our protagonist, lost in thought. Not an unusual occurrence, for he is, in fact, quite well versed in the concept of existentialism. Contemplating the disproportion between temporal vastness and one's own consciousness. Put plainly, the means by which one can recount the entirety of a courtship whilst smoking a cigarette. He arrived at this idea while pondering his past misfortunes with a woman he had hoped would accept his request to be his chérie d'amour. The pair had accompanied one another on several occasions and often frequented the Cactus, a pub notable for its intimate atmosphere and considered attention to the principles of feng shui. On the other side of the room sits our protagonist's friend of approximately 5 years, save for the couple of months in the latter half of 2004 when they had a small drunken disagreement and fell out over the correct rules of the card game Cheat. He is currently experiencing a phase of obsession, that is to say, he recently became aware of a man known by the name of Hunter S. Thompson. For those fortunate enough to avoid the dull ramblings of a drugged-up addict, Hunter S. Thompson was an eccentric drug fiend who rose to prominence during the 1960s. It was also his request that upon his death, his ashes were to be fired from a cannon by Johnny Depp. But I digress.
So get this right, 3 p.m. rise, 3:05, Shivas Regal and Dunhill with the morning newspaper, 3:45, cocaine.
As I was saying, quite the fanatic. It could be said our protagonist shares in this sentiment, although his addiction is of altogether an entirely different affair.
I mean, he's so methodical about it. I dispute the whole coleslaw taco salad thing, but no one's eaten that after snorting that much coke. Weed, have you?
Huh?
He smokes a joint at 6, and I've come this far, so as well, might as well go through the whole process, right?
Yeah. Top drawer, maybe.
Clove cigarettes, right? You can't buy these anymore, can you?
Don't believe so.
Anyway, you were saying something about a girl earlier?
Yeah.
I ran into her earlier today. First time seeing her since, you know, the breakup.
Which one's this then? The Converse and Hurry?
No, it was Doc Martens and Dungarees.
Oh, right. Go on.
He had never been a man of many words. Conversations were a language he had never quite mastered, although a couple of pints in the pub and he could put on a pretty good impression of a socially adept man. Oh, and all those well-timed cigarette breaks. He had always, and would forever be, it seems, one of those silent and stoic types.
It was just a chance encounter. I was waiting in line for a coffee, and she walks in there with some new guy on her arm, as if to say, fuck you, look at me now.
Bitter, isn't he?
Not that I'm bitter.
It began the way it always does, talking without really saying anything. She'd say, so, what do you study? And I'd say, creative writing. Oh wow, tell me more. And as time went on, ooh, I should refer you to my holistic therapist. She'd also say stuff like, my ego's died a few times, but I'm okay.
Wait, what?
But then, after a while, it was like we didn't even have to talk to communicate. We just kind of found these silences. Nah.
So, I spoke to Julie and Mark about maybe going over on Sunday night, if you could pick up a bottle of wine after work.
Mm-hmm.
Are you actually going to respond? Or we're just playing the usual black ball?
What? So you just speak to me in fucking anagrams now?
Don't! It always went like this. After the honeymoon period and straight into the inevitable mundanity of a real-life relationship. He was the type of guy that would romanticize you up into this concept and then flirt with the ordinary woman behind your back. Although, it wasn't the flirting that bothered me so much. Between you and me, he wasn't very good at it. He just lived in a fantasy.
Imagined relationships as though they were part of some romantic movie in which he was the protagonist. And what role was I left with? When you tell your friends about us, how will you portray me? The love interest? The villain? Doomed to be the narrator of your story. Don't you worry about a thing. Don't you worry about a thing.
Acid's kicked in then. It's weird. I've replayed the thing over in my head so many times. It almost feels
cathartic. Right?
Chance encounter. Waiting in. Sorry. Fuck off!